We need your help because our children are dying. That was the impassioned plea we heard today from a Ukrainian mother turned soldier who's now being trained by Australian troops. 70 Aussie personnel are on the ground in the UK, leading a 5-week combat course to help Kyiv's forces fend off another Russian offensive. Our Europe correspondent John Paul Gonzo reports now from the military base.
3,000 kilometres from their homeland and the front line, Ukrainian troops in the UK learning how to fight and survive from the world's best armies. 70 Australian troops are now part of a British initiative training these soldiers before they're sent to battle. Most are civilians with no previous military experience, among them this mother who we cannot identify for her own safety. She told us Ukraine is ready to fight till the end, but it cannot do it alone. We need your help, she pleaded, because our children are dying. The combat course compresses 5 months of basic training into 5 weeks. The focus, defensive shooting, anti-tank weapons, countering drone attacks and Russian trench warfare.
It's unbelievable the change that we see. I mean, every day they progress so much and they're learning so quickly.
The Deputy Prime Minister and Foreign Minister met with the soldiers today, an experience they described as profoundly humbling.
It will save lives and it will make an incredible contribution to enabling Ukraine to stay in this fight.
10,000 Ukrainians have now completed this training that is designed to make them more lethal on the battlefield. This program will continue for as long as it's needed.
Being one-on-one and hearing their individual stories as people, it's changed all of our perspectives, and I think it's something that every soldier, when they leave here, will take away.
What Australia won't do, at least for now, is send tanks to Ukraine, which the US and UK have both promised to do.
We will continue to assess what we need to do to make sure that we stand with Ukraine.
Kyiv has made it clear it cannot win the war without more armour. John Paul Gonzo for 10 News First, Southampton, England.